whatever.
Hello!
Hello!
Hello, everyone.
Hello, TV Land.
Welcome to McCracken at Midnight.
With Brian.
With Brian the Bassturd. With that guy.
Yeah.
Do you want to play a song?
I had a little song. McCracken at Midnight with Brian the Bassturd. Now it's time to start the show. I don't fucking know.
Midnight, where it's the show. So, today, if you'll notice, today, what day is it, Brian?
It's President's Day.
It's President's Day. It is the day where we honor the birthdays because they were so close together and they used to celebrate it together. They used to all just get together and celebrate their birthday in the same room. They used to have one whole cake.
Really?
George Washington, Abraham Lincoln, and somebody else that I can't remember off the top of my head.
Oh, yeah, they were all alive at the same time.
They were all alive at the same time. They would all eat cake together. It was excellent.
Strippers.
They would get...
They had crazy
colonial strippers. It was awesome. In Lincoln's time, they had Confederate strippers. They would just treat them just terribly. Anyway, so it's a president-themed show.
Allegedly
a president-themed show. Periodically throughout the night, Brian will be shouting out random presidential facts.
As quickly as I can find them.
Which would not be difficult. First fact, John F. Kennedy was the first Catholic president. Probably one of the only. So anyway, we have an interesting show planned this evening for you guys. We actually... have a plan, which is a first.
It's crazy, right?
We're talking about a couple things. We're going to talk about... let's just start out. For the past, I don't even know how long, at least 24 hours, something really weird has been playing on the SMFA TV. If you had watched at all, there were some videos of some guys.
One guy. Basically, this guy, and you guys are going to have to do your own research. This cat kept getting banned from YouTube, like, over and over. And I think it started out, he was just weird and, like, light dancing around, cross-dressed, and he'd make songs and he'd dance to them. Why? I don't know why. Whoever Yug Sothoth is...
Sothoth.
Whatever. They really weren't into this guy. I was watching it, and they were like... he was just like, just trashing on this dude.
Yeah.
And whatever you think about his videos, it's interesting what he's done. He kept getting banned from YouTube and, putting his stuff back up just cause, you know, it's supposed to be about, freedom of information. And that's what we're all about here.
So yeah, he kept creating new accounts on YouTube because his accounts would get banned. And he just created a new one. And he just kept doing that. I don't know what's going on with him now. Sam White knows the whole story. The owner of this, the manager, station manager. He knows all about this. But, yeah. So that's what's been going on there.
There's a whole website, by the way, called bannedfromyoutube.com. And it's all videos that got banned from YouTube.
It's very interesting.
It's mostly porn. And it feels like a porno site, but there's some other stuff on there, some weird junk. It's worth checking out if you don't mind sifting through porn.
There's some pretty... Oh, thank you, Yog-Sothoth. There's some pretty weird stuff on there. I'm going to take a quick picture of you guys for something. Excellent.
There's our audience.
That's the audience. Anyway, that's a pretty cool site. First video Brian showed me was this kid, obviously in the early 90s.
Late 80s,
early 90s, doing slam dunks on his tiny little, like, Space Jam stick-to-the-wall backboard.
About as tall as his head.
Yeah,
Great dunks. This kid,
7 feet off the ground.
This kid knew some shit, but it was like this tiny little fake. I mean, it would have been great if he could do it with an actual basketball and hoop.
It was hilarious. I quite enjoyed it. Anyway...
Hey, does anyone know how to do this?
What did you... Yeah, I know how to do that. Hey, what's up, man?
What's going on? How you doing tonight? Anyway, no one can see you, dude.
Anyway, so...
Popped off, yeah, you got it.
Popped up. Anyway, so here at SMFA, moving on to the next thing.
Oh, well, before we do that, John Quincy Adams was the first president to be photographed. Isn't that insane?
That is insane.
I mean, he wasn't photographed...
Six?
Something like that. Six. It's not while he was president.
It was before he was president.
It was after he was president?
After
he was out of office, they took a photograph of him. But still, it's crazy.
You know, I love the fact that presidents go out of office. Like, I think that's just such a funny thing. I mean, yeah, like, their term is a certain amount of time and stuff like that. But, like, you never know what the... And, of course, we do now because we have such, like, a strong media. But you never know what they do after that. Because they can never hold office again.
I'm pretty sure...
Because they were president. They can't hold a higher office. They can never hold office again. They can't really ever have another job unless it's, like, lobbyist.
I'm pretty sure Teddy Roosevelt, like, died of, like, some kind of horrible jungle fever while hunting tigers.
Well, that's pretty cool.
Yeah, that dude was badass. Kind of amazing.
That's awesome. But kind I mean, of like, horrible, but I mean, like, John Quincy Adams. What does he do? What, he retires to his house in Quincy? Like, is that what he does? I mean, that's why it's called Quincy, right?
Yeah. I think he just went and riched it up.
In Massachusetts, style. In, like, Western Massachusetts, something like that.
Yeah.
Anyway, I don't know. That was a good fact, though. So, anyway, here at SMFA, we have new bathrooms, which I wanted to talk about for a minute. The new bathrooms are space-agey and shitty. I have a picture for you. Let's see if we can hook that up. Can we get that up there, Brian? Do you think we can get that picture up there?
What picture?
I think we can get that picture up there. Look at the bathroom. Look at it.
It's it tries to discourage vandalism, which we're not down with.
It's also very dark. Also, at the sinks there's the soap dispenser, and it's an automatic soap dispenser.
Those things just remind me, I just want to like jerk them off and then they
it constantly is ejaculating into the sink just while you're
just
washing
like
your hands.
Me.
And it literally and it literally looks like ejaculate. Like it like, just keeps squirting under the thing and it looks just like ejaculate. No, I don't have footage, but I can get you footage of this thing ejaculating into the sink. That's not a bad idea. Anyway, these bathrooms. So yeah, they try to discourage vandalism. They have like glass walls, it's all ceramic tiles and stuff like that now.
But people aren't having it. There's one big glassy type white thing that people are already drawing all over. I was down there a couple minutes ago.
I was. Just I saw tonight. That. There's that brain on it.
Someone's added to it.
Yeah.
Yeah,
paint pens work very well.
Yeah.
Sharpies don't work so well, but paint pens, they work well. And then the stalls, you can still draw all over. I don't even know how they're going to try and discourage that. You can just draw with anything.
Yeah.
Anyway, new bathrooms. I don't know. We're thinking, Brian was saying we should paint a mural in there.
I'm
just
thinking
like a big, huge mural.
Landscapes and rainbows and
unicorns
just
with giant
beauty.
Dongs.
Yeah.
Yeah, so that's that. What else is on our list of things to talk about? We're moving kind of fast.
I'd love to be getting commentary from our usual crowd, but
yeah, where's our usual crowd? What's up with that?
But I think Yog-Sothoth is
Sothoth
is right there, and I think he types faster than a human being can, so I don't think it's a real person.
It must not be a real person.
Not a chance.
Is I a reals person? No, I'm real fast. You should keep that in the bedroom, buddy.
Yeah.
Just keep that. It's personal. Anyway, what else is going on? You got a new president fact?
Oh, shit. I'm dropping the ball on this.
Yeah, you're dropping the president stuff, man. I really like the wigs that presidents used to wear. You know, and parliamentary people and lawyers and stuff like that. They still wear them in Australia, I think, in Parliament. But they had those sweet, rolled, curler, white things on their heads, those wigs. They looked so, so good. Oh, real quick, Dana, hey, Dana, what's up? Is asking for a shout-out.
You're a funny girl, Dana, but we love you, so everybody should be friends with Dana, because she rocks.
There's a portion of the Secret Service, the President's Guard, who just are devoted to toilet security.
That's awesome.
Who just work, you know, around him pooping and stuff.
The President's poop. It's highly sensitive.
Presidential bathroom security is a whole branch.
It's a highly sensitive area.
Of the Secret Service.
His anus is often a highly sensitive area. It's irritated and raw. They don't collect the... I don't really know, nor do I want to know.
I don't think they have... It's the thing is a poop. I think it's once it's out of the president, it doesn't really matter. It's, you know, the president while he's pooping.
Yeah. They sometimes, maybe they track it as it goes through the U-bend. And then into the sewer. You know, they want to make sure it gets all the way to the sewer so no one can hijack it halfway there. And then clone the president from
something
his poop
like
or something.
That.
In any case, the wigs. I really like those wigs. Brian is searching for presidential facts.
Don't tell him. Don't give it away.
Right now. That's all I'm going to say. Anyway, so this SMFA TV thing. We're talking about issues tonight. You know, it's President's Day, so we're talking about real issues that matter. Anyway, there's this SMFA TV run by Sam White in here. This is actually his studio that we're in right now. He runs it, the whole thing, out of his studio. And he's graduating this year. And SMFA TV hopefully will continue into next year, but we don't really know. So we're looking for a permanent space in the school. And I was talking to Brian about this, and he brought up the really great idea that some of the film editing rooms, the 60mm film editing rooms downstairs with old Steinbeck machines.
Check this out. We have three Steinbecks, two six-bed, one four-bed, and plate. Six-plate, four-plate. And they're never all three of them occupied at once. Maybe sometimes two of them are. But basically, the four-bed one, I don't think we need anymore. I say, out with the old, in with the new.
Sell it.
Sell that
on
shit.
On the side of the road. Just put a sign on it.
Or
free or best offer.
Okay. That's one way to do it. But that's beside the point. You move out that four bed, put the two of them in one room, and then you just get this little room that you can just TV from.
It'll be like freaking Big Brother Confessionals, man.
And we can get, like, better stuff down there. If we had its own room, it would be taken more seriously, and, like, we could have a computer that doesn't, like, stop the feed every 15 seconds. No offense to Sam White, he's done amazing things. You know, we wouldn't have this show if it wasn't for him. And he's done so much with the unbelievably limited resources and support that he has.
Yeah.
But it's basically like we're dealing with the bare bones up here. We got a camera and a box and a computer and a file cabinet. Our buddy James almost lost his arm last week trying to
2 weeks ago, yeah.
Reach in there and...
He did great, though. His skinny little arms really reached in there. We were really happy with that. Yog-Sothoth is now just repeating everything we say. I don't really know what's going on there. Anyway, yeah. Brian, you're dropping the ball again.
Fuck.
So this SMFA TV, it's a totally awesome thing, and we just need to find a space. And the school has a lot of space, but no one knows how to use it, and everybody has a claim on every little space. It's just all so confusing and whatnot.
Oh, I have one off the top of my head. Musician... Oh, sorry, were you saying something?
No.
The musician, Hazel Atkins, he was a one-man band. He was one of the great psychobilly musicians of all time. He, until the day he died, everything he ever recorded, even just, you know, homemade stuff, he sent a copy of it to the president as soon as it was done.
Awesome.
Mm-hmm.
I wish I could send copies of things to the president.
You could. Hazel Atkins did.
I don't think you can anymore. It takes a little while to get to the president. Does it ever actually get to the president. I watch a lot of The West Wing, and I learned from that show, that fictional show, that President Dodgers actually read the letters you send him, but everybody that sends a letter to the president or to the White House gets a Christmas card from the president with the president's signature. Granted, it may be a, hey, will you plug me into the power strip there?
Who?
Will you plug me into the power strip? I'm in the wall. Granted, everybody, the signature of the president may not be hand signed. It's probably just printed on there. But Wagon Wheel is their only good song, and that's because it was written by Bob Dylan.
Whatever.
Okay. In any case, everybody that writes a letter to the White House gets a Christmas card from the president. How cool is that?
That's pretty cool.
Or at least that's how it is in the fictional universe of the West Wing.
I don't know.
But that's pretty sweet. I once wrote a letter to my congressman. I don't know how old I was. I must have been like 11. And I was talking about, I wrote him about a streetlight. When I lived in Virginia, I wrote him about a streetlight and how bad the traffic was at the streetlight, because I was always afraid that we were going to get in an accident when we went through the streetlight. And then my sister told me that it was ranked like one of the worst streetlights in all of like Virginia. Or
how observant of little 11-year-old Sam.
I know. I had a political mind at an early age. Anyway, I wrote a letter to my congressman. And then, like, the next year, I swear I got, like, an invitation in the mail to some thing. I don't even know, but it was, like, handwritten. It must have been something I don't know how anyone got it, but it said it was from whoever the congressman was at the time. And I didn't go, but I really wanted to, but my parents were like, no. Probably because it was, like, some creeper trying to kidnap me or something that maybe got my name from maybe a disgruntled page that stole the congressional mailing list and then sent creepy letters out to
me. I don't know, man.
I really don't know. That's my whole story. It doesn't have to do with the president, but there's a president pro... that's the Senate. President... The president doesn't like Congress, so that has to do with presidents. Anyway, yeah, presidents, man. It's pretty good.
Wow. Okay, how about this one? Here are presidents. We all know the presidents who were assassinated. Lincoln, Garfield, McKinley, and Kennedy.
Yeah.
Except we don't know who McKinley is or why he was assassinated.
William McKinley.
Yeah, I mean, I know who he is, but, like, why did anyone want to kill him?
I don't know. That's a good question.
Why would anyone want to kill Garfield? He was adorable. Big, fat dude with the beard. Anyway... How about the failed presidential assassination attempts? Jackson, Lincoln, I guess there was an earlier one. Roosevelt, Hoover, other Roosevelt, Truman, Kennedy, Nixon, Ford, Carter, Reagan, George H.W. Bush, Bill Clinton, George W. Bush, and Barack Obama.
Granted, those last four are going to be like, somebody got a letter that said, I'm going to kill the president.
Well,
and they probably counted that as an assassination attempt.
Yeah, who knows?
Or at least the last three. I think it's funny that the attempted assassinations get more and more frequent as the years go on.
Yeah.
Who? What's that last one? President's deaths
rumored
to
be
assassinated.
Zachary Taylor and Warren G. Harding. I don't know how either one of them died.
Click on William McKinley. I would like to know why somebody would want to kill William McKinley, because I really don't know. I knew he was assassinated.
McKinley.
In, like, a train station or something, right?
No, Garfield was a train station.
Oh, Garfield was a train station.
At the Temple of Music in Buffalo, New York. Oh, cool.
Buffalo.
Pan
oh,
American.
William McKinley. It was Chogosh. Chogosh Working Man.
Gosh.
This is, it's from the, I know the musical Assassins. He was at the Buffalo.
He was at some music thing.
Music festival, and Chogosh went up to shake his hand and shot him.
Who's Chogosh, aside from a dude with a cool fucking name?
Chogosh. I don't remember. Hang on, let me try to remember the song. He was like I don't know, he was some kind of worker. He was just like a middle-class guy who wanted to be famous or something like that.
Chogosh, let's find it.
You're right there. Leon Chogosh. Oh, and McKinley was alive for 8 days before he died. That's brutal, man.
Oh, he got shot and he was just hanging out?
Yog-Sothoth is recording this.
Oh, that's cool. Thanks,
dude. Yog-Sothoth.
I need to find out who you are and get that recording from you.
It does sound like a Lovecraftian elder god.
Yeah.
Yog-Sothoth. I'm starting to like you more and more. you need to let me know who you are so we can do it.
I have no fucking clue who you are.
And make babies.
Yog-Sothoth.
Making babies with Yog-Sothoth. Maybe it's something backwards. Hotohatos Goy.
Oh, it's my buddy Hotos. Yeah. I'm sorry, dude. I didn't recognize you. Or your name.
You know what? Dana and Wasted, typing. I can be as awesome. I can be as sexy as I want on here.
Dude, we're both wearing plaid. That's fucked up. I'm taking mine off.
I'll take mine off, too. I got a sweet dinosaur shirt underneath. I got my Ruckus shirt on.
I got my Lewiston Wheels swim team t-shirt
on. I'm gonna keep my own. Anyway, McKinley. William McKinley.
Okay.
So, what's next on our list? Oh, we're at Art and Stuff.
Art and Stuff. This is my favorite segment. This is our only recurring segment. It needs a theme song.
Art and Stuff.
That was FGC for you, those of you playing at home.
Art and Stuff.
Art and Stuff. Art and Stuff.
I think today on Art and Stuff, we're doing a little bit of shameless self-promotion, aren't we, on our new project?
Awesome shameless self-promotion.
Yeah.
Art and Stuff. Look, also, a face. So, Art and Stuff. Last Friday, I was animating robots, just because I wanted to animate some robots on index cards. I was just making, like 13-frame cycles of robots doing dance moves. And I was like, it's a robot dance party. That was the title of the animation. So I was like, whoa, robot dance party sounds awesome. I should make a website called Robot Dance Party. So I went to Robot Dance Party, which you all should do. Go to robotdanceparty.com. It's awesome. But it was taken, so I couldn't do robotdanceparty.com. So I was like, what am I going to do? So I just put awesome in front of it. And then it became Awesome Robot Dance Party. So now, Awesome Robot Dance Party is turning into this whole thing that isn't really a thing yet. You can't actually go to it yet. It doesn't exist.
We're still building it.
I own the domain, but we're still building it. Anyway, basically what it's going to be, there's going to be a front page that says Start the Party. And you're going to cursor over it, and it's going to go, shah! And then you click on it, and it takes you to another page where there's going to be embedded music that Brian is making, and it's awesome. Can you play a little bit in just a second? It's going to play that. It's going to embed that music. And then there's just going to be animations and pictures and videos of people dancing in robot suits and animations of robots dancing.
They're not people in robot suits.
No,
they're real robots.
I'm sorry, right. How could I say that? They're real robots. And then there's going to be some people dressed up heinously in robot suits. I don't know why anybody would do that because you can just be a robot. Anyway, there's going to be all these things. And they're all just going to be, it's going to be in grid format just all down the page. It's just going to say dance, dance, dance at the top. There's going to be bolts. And it's just going to be all this stuff. And it's just going to loop the music. And you can play all these videos. There's going to be GIFs. There's going to be images. There's going to be... All right, we have a little sample of the song for you now. Brian's gonna load it up. Brian's been working on it. It's not quite finished yet. No, play it from the beginning.
From the beginning?
Yeah.
It's kind of a long intro on it. Y'all can hear that? Dropped a frame.
Whoa. It's getting heavy. We've been listening to this so much. That it's completely embedded in my brain.
Goes on like this. I'd say check out Robot. You can just picture the robots. Anyway. I'd say check out awesomerobotdanceparty.com and like 3 weeks?
No, I'd say like a couple days. We're going to have a front video up there for a little while we're collecting various imagery and such so that we can turn it into a real thing. But there's going to be a video up there, just like an animation of what we have so far. And that's going to be up there for your viewing pleasure.
In just a few days. The plan.
Once we get James to build us a website.
It's easy to remember. Awesome Robot Dance Party.
AwesomeRobotDanceParty.com. When I was making the domain, we had a debate over
If it should be .com, because it was going to be just robotdanceparty.com, and we couldn't get do that. So we were wondering if we should just have a different suffix, and if it would be like robotdanceparty.biz or robotdanceparty.net, because those were the two we came down to. I really wanted robotdanceparty.ca, you know, all Canadian robots. But biz and net, we thought, were the two that sounded most robot-y. is James even watching this?
Anything
probably
with the
not
Z in
because
it.
I think he's drunk.
Well, dude, Yogg-Sothoth is drunk too.
Yogg-Sothoth probably
fucking,
is drunk.
He's not. He doesn't care. She doesn't care.
Anyway, what was I saying? But anyway, we just stuck an awesome in front of it because .com is just it's .com.
It's universal.
You get .com.
It's
awesome.
Commercial.
So anyway, this whole awesome robot dance party thing is going to be super. Excuse me, but awesome, because it's going to be a collection of things. And this is all coming out of a I think, a need, a desire I'm feeling towards a collectiveness feeling in the animation department here at SMFA. Brian made a production stamp that we're hoping people are going to put on their videos. It's SMFA animated shorts, and it's got some boxer shorts. And they wiggle a little bit. Anyway.
To close out the art and stuff segment.
Is that all the art and stuff we have to talk about?
Well, this is more art and stuff. Moving away from Awesome Robot Dance Party. Because there's nothing more we can say. Or were you in the middle of stuff? I'm getting distracted.
No, I wasn't really.
Basically, it's awesome. But, there's, we have now some presidential-themed art. Miss Justine Lay, I believe it's pronounced. Justine L-A-I. She's a painter, and she has done a series of paintings of herself having sex with every president
awesome.
Of the United States. I'm going to see if I can look some of them up, actually.
If you'll notice real quick, Yogg-Sothoth, you should talk about the cool new album you're producing, Brian.
Oh, yeah, that confirms my suspicions of who Yogg-Sothoth was.
Who
so there's this really horrible fucking album I'm producing. I'm really not pleased with the way it's going.
Got it.
It's terrible. No, it's great. I'm producing an album right now at the Monkey Palace, where we're having our second open mic night
on
Friday.
It's going to be awesome. Band is going to be playing.
Band's playing. Ossian's playing. And Chris O'Grady's playing. And this dude's the man, and he's a great songwriter, and his second album's coming out. It's called Horror Bunny, and we're working on it. We're doing
drum tracks
tomorrow
with
a former drummer from Jackson Pro.
Is it Horror Bunny or Horror Bunny?
The Horror Bunny.
Okay.
The theory is that if there is an Easter Bunny, there has to be a Horror Bunny. Because everything good in the world has something evil.
Like in the... Well, I mean, what about in Bill and Ted's Bogus Journey, where they're traveling through hell, and he enters the door. Deacon enters the door, and he... He enters the... Keanu Reeves enters the door, and the evil Easter Bunny's there. He's like, "You stole Deacon's Easter basket!" Arr! And then he's chasing him down the hall.
That's probably the Horror Bunny.
It's really fucked up, man.
That's probably the Horror Bunny.
In any case, new album, Monkey Palace.
Yeah,
open mic night.
So, come to the open mic night, see Chris O'Grady, see everyone else, party, get the new album when it comes out in like a month or something.
So wait, is that who Yogg-Sothoth is?
That's who Yogg-Sothoth
okay.
is.
Okay, that's
I gotta put that stuff up online somewhere too, because I have some live footage of that motherfucker.
Yeah, you do.
Playing. Of all of us playing. Not of you, not you.
Nah, not me.
We'll get some.
We'll see. We'll see how the rest... We'll see how the other half of Band is doing when we play.
Yeah.
Slash, we need to practice. Slash, talk about the fact that we have a band now.
I'm gonna throw some Justine Lay up on the up for you guys. What else do we have to talk about tonight?
That's the whole list. That's right. Literally the entire list. Oh, that made us half an hour though.
Yeah, we're doing better. We're doing better and better at this. I can
check it out. I drew a crappy Ice King.
He's not crappy. He's just skinny.
He is a little skinny.
Okay, apparently Yogg-Sothoth did a line of morphine off a katana sword last night. I actually did a line of morphine off a wakizashi. Is that what it's called, wakizashi?
Yeah.
Yeah, wakizashi. So mine was a little bit shorter than yours, but maybe just as effective.
Yours is a little shorter.
Oh, you have a wakizashi?
Hmm? I actually do have a wakizashi.
It's pretty sweet, man.
Yeah.
Those are the only two kinds of swords I know. Wakizashi and katana. Speaking of katana, what is the deal with Katana from the DC universe? Like, what is her power? I don't understand. Is she just a really good female samurai? Like, I don't totally understand, like, the point of her. She seems to be Batman, but female and from Japan. Which is fine. I'm all about Batman and females and Japanese things. But I don't know. I never really got Katana. And then in the whole Public Enemies arc, where, like, she's working for Batman secretly, and Captain Adam's like, Katana, you traitor.
I don't know, man.
I don't either. That's what I'm saying. Anyway, Ryan, what you got for us?
Justine Lay. How do you put it? Check it out. Here she is. I'm not going to be able to identify all these presidents.
That looks like Clinton.
I think that's her getting skanky with Clinton.
Or Harrison, maybe. Oh, yeah. Okay.
There's some good stuff. Oh, that's one of the same ones you just saw again.
That looks like a...
I don't know my presidents.
Let me see if I can get a images of all the presidents.
Oh, there she is getting spanked by
Ulysses S. Grant.
Ulysses S. Grant, I believe.
States.
That's filthy.
That's awesome.
That's great.
What else you got?
Oh, here she is getting it rough from is that Buchanan? He's one of the ones without.
They all look the same, and all in this like 17 to 22 zone, they all look exactly the same.
Yeah.
That looks like this guy right here.
No, he doesn't have a beard.
Oh, you're right. Maybe it's this guy.
Hmm? No. That's,
maybe this guy? Who's
that's him. That's him, yeah.
Who's that? That's, freaking Hoover.
That's Hoover. Yeah, that's Hoover, yeah. Damn, Hoover likes it rough, I guess.
Herbert Hoover.
Oh, man, here she is. There's, she's coming behind this guy, though, and that's, oh, that's, I know that. That's, that's Jackson.
That's Andrew Jackson?
Yeah.
No, that's not Andrew Jackson.
Who the fuck is that, then?
It's, oh my god, what? That's not big at all. That's, gonna be... That guy. White male. Oh, this is a bad list of people. Wait, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7... Van Buren. It's Martin Van Buren.
Van Buren? Okay.
I'm guessing it's Van Buren.
He's stuck with Van Buren. He doesn't look like he minds too much.
Nah, he's enjoying it.
This one's... I like the ones that aren't... there's Washington, of course.
Yeah, getting it with Wash. Oh, he looks sensual and sweet.
Yeah, you see, he's not gonna rough you up. No, he's gonna lay you down softly. And
he's gonna love you real good.
Yeah.
Gently and sweetly.
Yeah, I mean, there's a whole bunch.
Yeah, there's lots of good stuff. Oh, man, that was Van Buren. That was right.
Here we are on, going cowgirl, and getting a nice lean back.
Who's that guy?
Who could that be?
Taylor?
That sounds right.
Taylor, or Tyler, or one of those
Taylor,
guys?
Yeah.
Polk?
I don't know, man. See, the thing is, they're all... partially impressionist, so it's tough to tell, you know? Plus, I don't really know my presidents as it is.
It's pretty great, though.
Yeah.
You know, every year I learn...
That's Clinton!
Yeah, you're right, that is Clinton. Every year I try and learn all the presidents in order. And then
I think maybe she's got double ups, because that looks like Washington, too.
Yeah, that does look like Washington. Well, that one's not Washington, then. That's, oh, that's Jefferson, dude. That one's Jefferson.
That's Jefferson. That's Washington.
Jefferson had the ponytail.
Ah, here's my favorite.
Yes.
Fellatio on Lincoln.
Wow, he's got quite the nipple on him there.
Oh, yeah. What do people have to say about this?
Boobity, boobity. 6'8", weighs a fucking ton. Washington, Washington.
Oh, yeah, what the fuck is his name? The Brad Neely song about Brad Washington.
Neely. Brad Neely's a cool dude. Washington. Oh, what's that? Wait, click on that one.
That?
I don't even know what's going on there.
That's just a naked chick with six arms. All right, now we're
getting off topic.
Yeah, we're getting off topic.
I don't know if I like her boobs. They're kind of freaking me out.
Well, enough of that stuff.
Camera. Hooray, we're back. Look, we exist.
I guess that's it for art and stuff this week.
All for
Justine
art and stuff.
Lay, she's far out. Look into her.
She's pretty cool. She sounds like a real neat lady. Oh, look, that's now the preview screen.
That's good. we're doing good.
How many viewers we got? 8. We're holding solid at
holding
8.
Holding solid
viewers.
At 8.
What else is going on?
I don't fucking know.
I'm tired. I'm really tired.
I'm tired.
You gonna go home tonight?
What? I don't know.
I think I'm gonna go home tonight.
Hey, votes from all 8 viewers, even though one of them is us and one of them is us downstairs.
Yeah.
So there's 6 people watching. Votes. Where should I sleep tonight? Should I go home and risk being late to class? Or should I sleep here and get a shittier night's sleep?
Sothoff says take some meth. I don't know if that's the best idea.
Nah, dude. That's a bad idea.
Dana, do you have a say in this? Smiley face doesn't count. Sleep with Sam. Thank you, Dana.
I think I'm going to go with
it's
that.
It's be adorable. what else can I draw?
Hey, guys, what do you want Sam to draw?
What should I draw? Give me something to draw for you guys. I'll draw you all a picture. I'll draw you all a picture on the back of this. While Brian plays the ukulele. That's too many things to draw. Here's a rainbow. Wait, what else? Oh, a narwhal. I freaking love narwhals, man.
Sea einhorns.
Like Lois Einhorn?
Yeah, you know, einhorn, it's actually German for unicorn.
Is it really?
So I wonder if there's anything sexual about that, the naming of that character, Einhorn.
I love Lois Einhorn. Here's a narwhal and a rainbow.
Einhorn is Finkel, Sam.
What?
You love a man.
That's fine. I love Lois Einhorn. It's fine. Dude, I got the elephant feet on there. I did it. Those are the elephant. Penis, arms, elephant feet. Is that like a new person? Is that just like, hang on. Let's do just penis, arms, elephant feet. Pterodactyl. I can do that. Brian, you gotta talk about something while I'm drawing Pterodactyl.
I don't fucking know. Pterodactyl. Pterodactyl. You guys keeping up with the tentacle bear thing? When that was fresh? When everyone saw that Skyrim design, like, concept drawing of the bear eating the woolly mammoth, and everyone thought that the woolly mammoth's tusk was a tentacle coming out of the bear for some fucking reason, and everyone was like, yeah, tentacle bears!
You know what my favorite Skyrim thing going on is?
What?
It's the, here's your Pterodactyl. My favorite is the, there are so many YouTube videos of people
draw Tang's picture.
Monkey jumping over rainbow while enjoying a lollipop. Okay.
Yes.
There's so many videos on YouTube of this people fighting giants, and the giants swing at them once with a club, and the people fly a million feet in
the
air.
It's a glitch.
It's an awesome glitch, and it's hilarious to watch.
I hope they don't
every
fix
single
it.
Time.
I don't know. I like the took an arrow in the knee video personally. But
the animated one?
Huh? No. There's one that just it shows like a million guards saying like, I used to be an adventurer like you, but I took an arrow to the knee. And then it's followed
I kill
up,
the ones that say it, that to me.
It's followed up by like 5 minutes of this like metal and then this dude going around with arrows just shooting guards in the knee.
That's awesome.
Some of the same voice actors.
Just sing all the comments we get as lyrics to whatever I play.
Go for it.
So last week I got my hands on some voiceover scripts for Abigail, Brand, and Wasp. That was cool. Yes, please do it. Same thing harder. I don't control C. That Dick Cox jizz monkey. I like to fuck horses. Thunder comes, no why. From the Avengers animated thingy that is on TV and stuff that thing because come home with me tonight. I shove that horse in my butt. I'm Bigfoot, love slave, modulation, messy huntsmanies, messy huntsmanies, huntsmanies, cocko cock, cocko cock, cock on.
Penis. Okay. That was good.
Shove horses in me.
Anyway,
Is anyone not familiar with the Ben Folds tour where he just went on chat roulette and projected?
Oh, I love that.
You guys know this? He projected his chat roulette screen up on the board behind him and just went through chat roulette and improvised and sang about all the people who came out, and they could see him in the audience behind him.
And then there was he did this because there was a guy going around on chat roulette with his hood all tied up and stuff like that, and he played the piano and he would play about the people that he was looking at, and people thought he was actually Ben Folds because he had the box frame glasses and stuff like that. So people thought this guy on chat roulette was Ben Folds. So then Ben Folds heard about this and did this on his tour. And then at one point, he actually ran into the Ben Folds guy. And they were singing about each other. It was the funniest thing.
That's fucking
ever.
Epic. I've never been on chat roulette.
It's a weird thing.
Is it all penises now? Has it degraded to that point?
It hasn't at all. I haven't been on it in a while. I actually did a huge project about it last year, a year and a half ago. I printed out this huge, I went on, and I saw a good number of boobs, believe it or not.
Really?
Yeah, a couple of boobs. Couple of five-year-old kids. Anyway, I did this huge project on it in photo. I went on and I took like a billion screenshots. I took a screenshot of every single person I saw.
Regardless
of what it was. And I made a huge, it's 9 feet long. I still have it. It's all rolled up in my room. A huge 9 feet long grid. Just grid of screen after screen after screen after screen. I really gotta hang that up somewhere. It's
yeah, Tang, you read my mind, man. We should have a chat roulette portion of the show.
We really should have a chat roulette.
I don't know if we have time to set that up. We only have 10 minutes.
We only have 10 minutes
of the show tonight.
We could spend the last 10 minutes. I don't know if we'll have to test that because I don't know if the bandwidth can handle it.
Yeah, but we'll look into it for you guys.
Because I think we would be extra good on that.
We're already improvising an hour of show. And seem to be keeping people entertained. Still have 8 viewers.
Okay, Softbop. Here, this is for you. This is someone shoving a walrus into another person.
Are they like jamming it in there with a cricket bat
just,
or something?
No,
on the
he's
other
just
end?
Pushing. Okay. He got the tail in and out.
Oh, that's
to
the two arms.
Him.
I get it. Yeah.
And now he's trying.
I think he's going the wrong direction. He should have started from the head.
No, because the head's too big and he couldn't get the tusks in there first. You know what I mean? So he's starting at the tail.
And by the time he gets up there, it'll be loosened up.
Loosened up a little bit.
I get your reasoning is sound.
Oh, I'm sorry, lame face. Let me draw you a dino, which is pretty ambiguous. Dude, make a machinima of that. What is that?
It wouldn't be a machinima if it was, like, drawn on paper.
What is machinima?
It's animation, like, cartoon video thing done via a video game.
Oh, cool.
You know what? The first thing we ever did on this show was draw a picture of an iguanodon and hold it up to the camera. So you're taking us, we're having a throwback now to,
he's gonna have a person.
He needs a saddle.
Yeah, I was gonna say he needs someone riding on him. Get a little stirrup in there. let's make it a teddy bear. Let's just make it a teddy bear riding on him.
Why the crap not? Skinny legs for a teddy bear.
Sorry. Alright, there is a teddy bear riding a dino who has a skull and crossbones tattoo on his butt.
His rump, really.
His rump.
Where does a dinosaur's butt?
It's
because, well, like, if you talk about a cat's butt, you'd be like, oh, I'm going to touch him in the butt if you touch it above the tail. But really, the cat's butt is under the tail.
Well,
you can fucking see it there.
My theory is that, dinosaurs' butts, at least the quadruped dinosaurs' butts, are similar to cow butts. And that they turn upwards under the tail. They just happen to have much bigger tails, so you can't tell, you know.
Wait.
Because, like, cow butts, they're like, here's the back of a cow, right?
Yeah.
And you got the tail hanging down. And the butt is like that. It's like a shelf right there. It's like a thing like that.
And then the tail. Cows have a shelf butt?
Yeah, they have a shelf butt. They got.
Okay, well, we're gonna look it up on here so we can show it to everybody.
I'm pretty sure they do at least. See, they got this like.
Does anyone know what a cow butt looks like?
Here you go. See, they got this like shelf butt.
Wow, shelf butt. Hold on a second, you guys, check this out. This is crazy shit.
Cow shelf butt. Cow butt.
Hold on, hold on.
I love a little cow butt in the morning. I love a little cow butt.
Where'd you find that? Where'd you find that, dude?
Right there.
Wake up with the cow butt on my face.
I don't know if you guys can make this out, but basically we got this kind of here's the cow's butt.
Okay, so you got the tail. You got the tail right here, right? And I wish you could draw this. You got the tail, and then this is the rump of the cow. This whole thing right here is the rump, and then you got this hole right here, which appears to be an extra large anus.
I think it's like a, kind of an anal.
It's like a cavity.
Anal cavity.
It's like an anal antechamber.
Yeah.
It's the anal foyer, if you will. from that, we go into the anus.
But it seems like what we're talking about is right here. This is actually it's tough to see because we're in two dimensions now. But this direction is actually coming out. So there'd be kind of this level, this precipice.
Here, we find a slightly better picture.
Let's find one in profile.
Where was that?
No.
I can't find it now. Here, this one might work. Oh, it's not gonna want to work. Yeah, there you can see it there. If we zoom in real nice and close, like.
Well, I'll tell you how you can zoom in. Use this shit.
Oh yeah. Zoom in real close on that guy. So you can see it's kind of like it's perpendicular to the ground. The anal antechamber. The anal foyer is perpendicular to the ground.
We have a little.
So it catches rain.
I think that's a cow vagina also right there.
Yeah.
Am I wrong about that?
No, I'm not quite sure.
I think we're getting
getting the whole package here.
In this place, kind of confused. I don't know.
We're getting the whole thing. In any case, that's what cow butts are like. And just to go back to.
Cows have weird butts.
Cows have weird butts. And I lost my train of thought, so I don't remember what I was going to talk about. What was I going to say, guys? Help me out here. What was I going to mention? What were we going to talk about? That's our preview image now. Look at that. That's nice.
Good.
Speaking of cow butts, is that what I was gonna go on with? I don't remember. Brian, any more presidential facts?
I'm looking for a good sign-off one.
Let's talk about presidents real quick. The first one was Washington. He had a wooden tongue for a good period of his life. Second one was Adams. He defended
the British. I thought he had wooden teeth.
Sorry, wooden teeth, not a wooden tongue.
No, that would be way worse.
That was from something else. That was a joke from something. The second president was John Adams. He was the lawyer defendant of the British soldiers that were involved in the Boston Massacre. The third president was Thomas Jefferson, who we all know actually wrote the Declaration of Independence, or at least outlined it, and did his best. The fourth president is another president. The fourth president is James Madison, who is from Virginia. The fifth president is James Monroe, who drafted the Monroe Doctrine, and I don't remember what the Monroe Doctrine was, but he did that. The sixth president was John Quincy Adams, who was the son of John Adams, and he, I believe, was a congressman beforehand or something like that. Andrew Jackson is on the $20 bill. He is the seventh president.
Martin Van Buren. The gang sign for the Van Buren boys is this, just so you guys know, because he was the 8th president. Ninth president was William Henry Harrison, who was only president for, I believe, 9 months because he refused to wear a coat to his inauguration.
It wasn't even that. It was 30 days.
30 days. He refused to wear a coat to his inauguration, got sick, and died in office. 30 days. John Tyler, James Polk, Zachary Taylor, those are three that I literally know nothing about because I don't care about them, nor does anybody else. Millard Fillmore has a funny name. Millard. Hilarious. Franklin Pierce. Oh, Franklin Pierce is the 4th one that I know nothing about because I don't care. James Buchanan is apparently literally the worst president ever. Is that what people say? He was the worst
president? Yeah, he's sucked.
15th president is... Oh, well, that was 15. 16th is Abraham Lincoln, who wrote the Emancipation... Proclamation.
What can you say about Abe, you know?
He got shot in the head. He owned a stopwatch.
Shot in the head and lived?
He got shot in the head. You know, I've actually been to Ford Theater.
Yeah.
I stood in the president's... Or I didn't stand in the president's box, but I stood behind the president's box. And then I went across the street to the house where he died. They just carried him right across the street after John Wilkes Booth shot him in the head. They carried him across the street, and he was in a bed. And the bed still has his blood all over it. It's amazing. It's one of the coolest things I've ever seen. 17th is Andrew Johnson, who also has a funny name. Andrew. 18th is Ulysses S. Grant, who is the first president to kind of go with the two presidents after a war is usually a war hero. Ulysses S. Grant was the general of the North and beat Robert E. Lee in an arm wrestling match at Appomattox Courthouse in Virginia.
Let's just do this for the rest of the show.
To win the Civil War. Next is Rutherford B. Hayes. Which I gotta say, I don't know anything about. Does anybody know anything about Rutherford B. Hayes?
He wrote the Hayes Codes, which promoted censorship in Hollywood during the 1950s.
Interesting.
Yeah.
Next is James Garfield.
Fattest
president.
Custom-made bathtub because he was so corpulent.
He got stuck in the bathtub in the White House. Oh, who was it? I don't remember who it was. It might have been Johnson, I think. One of them installed running water in the White House. I don't remember who it was, but it was around this time. Next is, where are we? Chester A. Arthur, who... was also not a very good president, I think. I'm pretty sure people didn't like him very much. Grover Cleveland. His name is Grover. And
the city of Cleveland is named after him.
City of
Cleveland. I don't fucking know.
We're gonna get to his interesting fact in a second. Next is Benjamin Harrison, who is, I have no idea if he is related to William Henry Harrison, but had a much better term if he was. And here we go again, Grover Cleveland. His interesting fact is that he was elected twice, but not until after another guy was elected.
Non-consecutive terms.
Not the only president to serve non-consecutive terms.
I don't know that happened. Did he give up, or people were like, nah, you fuck you.
I really don't know.
They were like, nah.
What's also interesting is that this was before the 23rd Amendment? 24th Amendment prevented... 23rd? Prevented presidents from serving for more than 8 years, serving for more than 2 terms. Next is William McKinley, who there's McKinley High School, which I'm sure is a high school somewhere. Theodore Roosevelt, Teddy Roosevelt,
killed an elephant. That was my last fact for the night. You're all over this shit.
He loved national parks. He founded many a national park. William Taft.
He was also fat.
Billy Taft, super fat, turn of the century. Well, actually, not turn of the century, but we'll just call him turn of the century because that's how I remember him. Woodrow Wilson.
People didn't like him either, did they?
He was a racist.
Mm-hmm.
He very much enjoyed the fact that people didn't like black people.
Mm-hmm.
Or Jews.
Yeah, he sucked.
Also, he was World War I, which was not a fun war for anybody. 14 to 1919?
Sounds about right.
Not a fun war.
a bad, 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 bad war.
Which made another even, kind of caused another even worse war a few years later.
Yeah. World War One was the first war to use airplanes.
And tanks.
And tanks.
And machine guns and basically everything. And chemical weapons and basically everything that sucks in war.
Yeah, World War One was just terrible at war. And no thanks to Woodrow Wilson.
And it was just fucking racist's fault.
He was super... He was such a racist. Oh, he was a racist. He basically loved the Ku Klux Klan. Let's just put it that way.
He loved the Ku Klux Klan.
He was all over their faces. Warren G. Harding is next, who is the 29th president. That's his interesting fact. Next is Calvin Coolidge, who I only like because his first name is Calvin, like Calvin Hobbes, and his second name is Coolidge, like a cooler that cools your drinks. That's the only reason I like him, is because of his name.
Which is reason enough.
Herbert Hoover, a terrible president. Nobody liked him. He ran the economy into the ground.
Got a worse rap, I think, than he deserves. He was more ineffective than actually shitty, but I mean, I guess that's as bad, right?
That is just as bad. Ineffective is the same as apathetic or lazy.
Yeah.
He had a vacuum named after him because
of his eating habits, I believe.
Yeah, probably. Just all the food. Next,
he would have stuff liquidate.
Is Franklin Delano Roosevelt, who served 4 terms in office.
He was
4 terms. He was the last president to serve more than 2 terms. He served 4 terms in office. He had polio and thusly was in a wheelchair.
But he didn't tell anyone.
But he didn't tell anybody.
Which is pretty hard shit to hide, if you ask me. But yeah. He pulled it off.
He ran World War II. He was an excellent wartime president.
Kind of pulled the country out of the depression with
pulled the country out of depression with Reconstruction. Winning the war also helped that a lot.
Despite all this, he was an elitist and a racist.
He was.
And he fucked his cousin.
Also, his wife was super ugly.
And his cousin.
And his cousin was super ugly. Next is Harry Truman, who is a bastard because he dropped a bomb. Actually, 2 bombs.
Japan did, like, you know, send their army to, like rape entire populations of China.
Proportionate response, though. Proportionate response.
Yes. What?
I don't think that dropping 2 bombs that destroyed populations and made those cities just unlivable for years and years.
I think the people of Hiroshima would be, yeah, I think they should be fortunate that their women didn't get literally raped to death.
Also, the United States had no part in dropping that bomb if it's China's women that were getting raped.
I guess.
I
don't know, man.
Atomic warfare, I think, is the worst thing to happen to the country.
I think it's the best thing to happen to the planet, because eventually it's going to kill all the people, and I'm down with that. But, roaches can happen. But this is a conversation for another night.
That's true. America did lose 250,000 people. I still don't think that atomic bombs are good. Okay.
Well, the thing is, this is a debate. Now, who's our president we're talking about again? This was
Truman.
Yeah, here's the shitty thing about Truman. He's not a shitty president. He had a fucked up decision he had to make.
No, that's absolutely true. No. I don't place the blame on him.
Yeah.
He did what he had to do. I think any president in his position would have done the same thing. That just doesn't mean I like it. I'm not saying it was his fault. I'm just saying I don't like it. Atomic warfare. I just think it's bad. Next is Ike Eisenhower. Dwight D. Eisenhower.
I like Ike.
I know nothing about him. I'm pretty sure he is one of the most worthless presidents.
I know that I like Ike. No. I think he was a big deal because, I mean, that was the start of the Cold War, and that was right when shit gets...
That's true.
He, from what I understand, contributed a lot to the Cold War setting in the way that it did.
Cold War also sucked.
Cold War also sucked.
Not as bad as World War One or World War Two, but it still sucked.
Yeah.
Dwight D. Eisenhower, he was a dude. John F. Kennedy...
He was from Boston.
He was from Boston.
So I like him.
I think he is a great guy.
He was Catholic.
He was Catholic.
You can forgive him for that.
That's Boston. Boston Irish Catholic. That's what happens.
First Catholic president.
First Catholic president.
As we said earlier.
A redhead.
Had brothers all over the place. And they all got shot. What do people have
against these people? They all got shot. I know.
His kids are in plane crashes. You know, and there's like a curse on the Kennedys.
John F. Kennedy, he was a cool guy. He was a pretty good guy. Robert Kennedy, an even better guy, didn't even make it into the running. He was running the primary. He wasn't even elected as the... They were Republican, right? Was he Republican or Democrat?
I don't know.
I don't remember how it was back then. In any case, that's what happened there. Robert Kennedy, great guy. And then Ted Kennedy. Ted Kennedy is just a good guy. He was a good guy.
He also, his funeral was like 6 blocks away from...
I was at his funeral.
From my apartment when I was moving into it. So it was really...
I was at the funeral. I was standing next to the church. It was raining. I stood in the rain for 2 hours. And it was just one of the saddest days ever.
He was pretty much the man.
He was a great guy.
Yeah.
He was a good guy. Anyway, next is Lyndon B. Johnson. Another Johnson. Not Andrew Johnson, but Lyndon B. Johnson, who just a doofus, I'm pretty sure. Anybody know about Lyndon B. Johnson? Anything at all? No. Richard Nixon. I just watched All the President's Men, which is one of my favorite movies of all time. Richard Nixon was a messed up dude.
Very eloquent speaker, though. Me and my father listened to his audio memoirs recently. And he had his shit together. Whole segment on talking about, you know, how presidents' drinking habits, as far as it related to their their political shits, like how they drink before speeches and how they drink before meeting people and how the dude from England was a lush. I don't know, whatever. But he was nuts.
He was nuts. I'm pretty sure, I don't know this for sure because I don't know enough of presidential history, but if I were to guess, I would say that he is the closest we have come to an actual corrupt president. He did a lot of really crappy stuff. Lots of spying, lots of money laundering, giving money to people he shouldn't give money to. And it wasn't all him. It was just, you know, those second in command.
He had a bunch of shitty cronies.
Advisors. Not a good guy. He resigned because nobody liked him. Actually, a lot of people liked him, but you know, Gerald Ford is a goof.
Yeah, I just remember the episode of Simpsons with him on it.
Do you like nachos and football? That's all.
Yeah.
Jimmy Carter.
Jimmy Carter was also on The Simpsons.
He was also on The Simpsons.
He builds houses for poor people. Or at least he did until he died.
Yep.
Yep.
Ronald Reagan was an actor. Actually, was in a play in the town in Back to the Future.
Yeah. Was he the oldest president we ever had?
I think he might have been the oldest president we ever had.
He named a defense system after a science fiction movie.
Star Wars.
Yeah.
Shitty defense system, can we just say that?
Yeah.
A worthless defense system. Reagan's, cost a lot of money and did nothing.
Backed the neutron bomb. He was probably... Okay, fuck. Nixon. Reagan was the craziest fuck we ever had as president. That guy did a lot of weird shit.
Also, he ran for president. Will you look this up real quick? How many times did he run for president? He ran for president, like, I swear, like 10 times. For 40 years he ran for president before he got in or something like that. Not literally 40 years, but a lot of years.
He was the governor of California?
Yeah, he was the governor of California. He was an actor.
He ran in 76, he ran in 80, and he was elected in... No, 81. Okay, yeah.
You're okay, wrong. So he ran twice before he made it. At least he was committed. Next is George Herbert Walker Bush.
George...
I don't even have anything to say.
what I know about him is he was George W.'s father, and that scene at the beginning of Big Lebowski when he goes, "This will not stand." And
also,
that's pretty much
that
all
same
I got
episode of The Simpsons with Gerald Ford.
Oh, yeah.
Where he does donuts on the lawn of Homer and Marge, and the donuts actually make the shape of a hammer and sickle.
Yep.
He really liked Mr. Gorbachev. He and Mr. Gorbachev were sensual lovers, let's just put it that way. And I have nothing more to say about him, because I just have nothing more to say. William Clinton.
Best president ever.
Best president ever. He was a great guy.
Played saxophone, fixed, like, the budget, balanced the budget. Like, are you kidding? Like, hasn't happened from him. That's unheard of these days. Balanced the budget. We actually had a budget surplus during Clinton's administration. He got a blowjob from a temp.
Yeah, extramarital affairs aside.
No. I'm saying that as a positive. Like, oh, okay. Who else has, you know, maybe it doesn't speak well to his character, but, like, to have a president, like, chilled out enough to be like, yeah, come, like, blow me in the office. It'll be awesome. I'm fucking my secretary. Like, that takes a special kind of person.
And then went on to host a TV show where all the men wore masks and the woman had to choose without seeing their face.
That's sweet. You see? Nothing wrong with her.
Also, yeah. Anyway, he was a cool guy. George W. Bush.
We all remember what happened, and I think we'd rather not talk about it.
We can just skip him.
Yeah.
And Barack Obama.
I think we all remember that, too, and I don't want to talk about that either.
Yeah, let's just... he's not... bad.
Yeah, you know, he's not bad, but...
He's not bad, he's just not...
He's what made me realize that politics has no hope.
We've talked about this before on the show.
Yeah.
We don't need to get into this again. But, who's saying racist things?
No, not racist, as in...
Play a song. Oh, hey Amari, thanks for
finally
logging
on. Hey, dude, it's Amari. What's going on, dude?
Amari, I'm so glad you're watching our show.
There you go.
Amari, you missed our dance.
By the way, we're 15 minutes over time.
Wow. We are getting shut down by the networks right now. Pirate broadcasting happening right now. Whew, we're going to get some fines, too. Lots of swears.
Yeah. Hey, prime time. Or wait, not prime time. Late night.
Late night.
Prime time, they can do what they want. They're not competing with us.
Nada. So yeah. Hang on.
Hey guys, this is over.
I was trying to play the song from Dr. Strangelove.
Yeah, we can't do this shit anymore.
It's time to leave because I need to go home and go to bed. Also,
yeah,
my back
fuck
hurts.
This.
And Yogg Sothoth.
Yeah, Chris, you gotta go to bed, dude.
Yeah.
We got work to do tomorrow. You don't sound so good. I'm a little worried about you.
I think maybe you've fallen asleep on the enter or the copy and face. Copy paste.
Nah,
button.
He's doing that on purpose.
Yeah, I know. Okay.
We got work to do.
Ryan,
last
question of the day. Last question of the night. Who is the funniest president?
We already talked about this.
No, the funniest president. Who was the funniest president?
Oh, funniest, I mean, to look at? I'd have to go with Hoover.
I'm going
to
go with Van Buren, man. He had some sweet mutton chops, and he was bald.
I got to go with Hoover. That dude was a delight. No. Sorry. Teddy Roosevelt.
Yeah,
Teddy Roosevelt cracks,
man,
my ass up. Guy was fucking crazy.
Yeah, he was
I crazy. Don't care. Let's. They gotta go around. South America. Fuck it. Let's just blast a hole
Let's
in Mexico.
Let's cut a hole straight through Panama. Let's just cut a hole in Panama. That'll be fine. No one will die of malaria. It'll be fine.
It's fine. Malaria and yellow fever. Nobody cares.
Speak softly. Carry a big stick. Good night.